Precious memories, unseen angels, sent from somewhere to my soul. How they linger ever near me, and the sacred past unfold. Precious memories, how they linger, how they ever flood my soul. In the stillness of the midnight, precious sacred scenes unfold. Precious Father and loving Mother, fly across the lonely years, and old home scenes of my childhood in fond memory appear. Precious memories, how they linger, how they ever flood my soul. In the stillness of the midnight, precious sacred scenes unfold. Mother praying, Father too, on bended knee. The sun is sinking, shadows falling, but their prayers still follow me. Precious memories, how they linger, how they ever flood my soul. In the stillness of the midnight, precious sacred scenes unfold. How they ever flood my soul. In the stillness,
you have delivered me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. And whosoever liveth and believeth in me shall never die.
None of us live unto himself. No man dieth unto himself. For whether we live, we die unto the Lord. Whether we die unto the Lord. Whether we live, therefore I die, we are the Lord's.
We draw nothing to this earth, that we cannot carry nothing on. Lord, be a custom.
Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who according to the grace, mercy, the God of us, again unto a living hope by the resurrection of Jesus Christ.
from the dead, unto inheritance incorruptible, undefiled, that which never fades away. The hymn number one of the program, my hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness. We dare not trust his sweetest faith, but only lean on Jesus' name, on Christ the solid rock.
Thank you.
14 to 19.
Upon the moon and unto the love, and all
said that for everything there is a season and a time for every matter under heaven. A time to born, to be born, and a time to die. A time to plant, and a time to talk about this plant. A time to kill, and a time to heal. A time to break down. And I make my duty not to make my father wait up to buy the Dina anymore. So even before he comes in, oh my grandpa Dina, I'll be out here looking for the Dina to buy. And it stays with me throughout life. I'm not just myself, but his sons and daughter that we stay late in bed and wake up early, you know, go and buy Dina and do something. My father, I can not shame to say this, he actually taught me to read. I love my mother's encouragement. I said, go on, Omar, don't worry, father will take me on the bar. And I said, read it in and ask him to read and something. I don't want to do it. I feel embarrassed that I can't read. You know, but my father ensured that to read the paper. And even coming down here this morning, I ensure that I bought my son Dina to hand it to my mom. And even while visiting here, while he was in, after I'd go on my own and come to visit my father, I sometimes think, as I said before, my father was like an educator. At the widest range of encyclopedias. I was an encyclopedia. I didn't have to go to the library to research anything. I found an interest in education. My father loved cricket. He loved boxing. So then the battle was going on, my father was in there and we were there with him and, you know, punching and, yeah, you know, enjoy boxing. We also listen to our series. We love music. We love soca, rock steady, reggae. When I was a little boy, I remember my father playing something like this. And especially when my father earned funds, money, my father would dance. You know, that's a good time, you know? And those spirit is right here with us, we're dancing now.
All is peace.
between these hollowed walls, reflect life. All our eight brothers and a sister around. We are sorry that it takes incidents like these to pull us that close. But I want us to reflect on Psalm 39:4. Lord, make me to know my end and the measure of my days, what it is that I may know how frail I am. The psalmist David was speaking here about the frailty and the brevity of life. Example, in Psalm 90:6, it says, in the morning it flourishes. In the morning we are strong. In the morning we are bold. In the morning we are beautiful. In the morning we are the best of the best. But in the evening, it's wither and perish. Our brother dying here this morning is an indication to all of us that one day, we too will lie in that bed. That no wife will be there with us, no children, nobody. We alone will lie in that bed. Therefore, it is important for all of us that while we are strong, while we are beautiful, while we are energetic, we shape our conduct. Because in the end, one day, we have to meet our Maker. And the story is told of a man who went to heaven. And we saw St. Peter. He said, St. Peter, I was a good man on earth. And St. Peter said, these are all the avenues in heaven. These are all the lanes in heaven. These are all the highways in heaven. These are all the duplex in heaven. And so Peter walked along with him. I said, Peter, well, there is some of that beautiful house there and that one there. Where are you taking him to, Peter? Peter looked at him and said, all these homes you see here in heaven were built by saints. Saints, children of God, who send the material to build these beautiful homes. But I'm sorry, my friend, the material that you sell to heaven could only build this house in that corner. And that's the corner you are going to spend your eternity. So in the morning when we are bold, in the morning when we flourish, the psalmist is dead. We should say, Father, I thank you for this new day. I thank you for sparing my life. I thank you for my spouse. I thank you for my children. I thank you for my siblings. Because one day, you and I will have to meet the Redeemer. Notice, life rapid chancing. I remember in 1973, when I went to college, he was living on Anthony Road. And that is 47 years ago. It was like yesterday. But it is 47 years ago. So therefore, we, all of us, need to shape our conduct and to be careful what we agree, because we one day will have to face the eternal King. The third one I want to talk to us about is 1 Corinthians 15:54. So, when this corruptible shall have put on incorruption,
that we want to see our loved ones who have gone on before us. We now have to shape up ourselves. We now have to put away the things that are not God. Put away the things that we should not be doing.
Yes, sir.
And come now and face our God. And our God says, He says, man is a worshiping being. And so man must worship God morning, noon, and night. And so all of us here must examine ourselves and put away things that are or not to be. And place ourselves in a place where He's gone to prepare for us. God says, Jesus said in John chapter 14 verse 2, I go to prepare a place for you. I, Christ, go to prepare a place for you. Now if Christ is gone to prepare a place for us, Christ is expecting to come for us and to take us into that place. But that place that Christ is gone to prepare is for prepared persons. It is for prepared persons. It is for those whose clothes are washed. Washed with the blood of the Lamb. Are their sins, are their stains on the garment that we wear? Regardless of the sins and the stains, our God, that we wear, whosoever come to me, I will no wise cast out. Oh, everyone that thirsted, oh, everyone who wants Christ, come to me. I will have to have no money, no pride. Just come to me. And Jesus said, you will come to me, I will not cast out. I'll make you wise. So my nephews and nieces, my siblings, my in-laws, this is a pointer to all of us. All of us that if we are not right with God, it is time for us to make it right with God. Because one day, we too will be lying like Him. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Let us pray. Oh God, our Father, Almighty God, sympathizing Jesus, wonderful counselor, mighty God, we bow before you, Lord. We ask the Lord to rise and touch all the brothers and sisters, the wives, the children, the grandchildren, the siblings. Lord, bind us together, Lord, with cords that cannot be broken. Bind us together, Lord, with cords of love, cords of sympathy, cords of empathy. Bind us, Lord. Bind us, Lord. And we thank you, Lord, that we are assembling this fashion. Lord, so our faces differ, so our needs. Bless us accordingly. Bless us individually, Lord. Bless us collectively, Lord. Christ's sake. Amen. I'm going to pray as a leader and you as God. God, we pray for our brother Archibald. Let us pray to the Lord Jesus Christ who said, I am the resurrection and the life. Lord, you console Martha and Mary in their distress. Draw us near who mourn for Archibald. Dry the tears of those who weep. Lord, you wept at the grave of Lazarus, your friend. Comfort us in our sorrow. Lord, you raise the dead to life. Raise our brother Archibald to eternal life. You promise receive who repented. Bring our brother to the joys of heaven. Our brother Archibald. Let our faith be our consolation and eternal life of hope. Grant all rest to your servant Archibald with all the saints. Where sorrows and pain are no more, neither this time, but life everlasting. You are immortal, the creator and maker of mankind, and we are mortal form of the earth, and the earth shall be returned. For so did you ordain when you created me, saying, you are dust, and to dust you shall return. All of us go down to the dust, yet even at the grave we make our song. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Into your hands, O merciful Savior, we commend our brother. Acknowledge, we humbly beseech you, a sheep of your own flock, a lamb of your flock, a sinner of your own redeeming. Receive him into the arms of your mercy, in the blessed rest of eternal peace, and to the glorious company of saints in light. Amen. In paradise, Archibald, the angels will lead you. At your coming, may Martha receive you and bring you into the holy city Jerusalem. Amen. The family of Archibald Mcleish, his wife, his sons, three sons and a daughter, their significant other, Amara's wife, and the others and the children around and the grandchildren, want to emphasize with all of us and to thank all of us who take time out to be here with them in this their moment of sorrow. We thank you most sincerely because these are not ordinary time, and you time out to be here with us. Your company is really appreciated. And may God bless you as you go back to your various places. We'll stand for the recessional hymn. A 5 minute shout at the end.
Good boy. Omar. Omar.
Isn't anybody want to drink and can't drink and drink? If you want to drink, you can drink. Our peace goes.
Man that is born of a woman has but a short time to live and is full of mystery. He comes up and is cut down like a flower. He fled as it was a shadow and never continued one state. In the midst of life, right death, of whom we may succor, but of thee, O Lord, who all our sins are justly displeased. Yet, O Lord, God Almighty, Father God, you are merciful God, deliver us from the bitter pains of eternal death. Lord, you know all the secrets of our hearts. Shut not your merciful ears unto our prayer, but spare us, most holy God. O God Almighty, holy and merciful Savior, Lord, you are worthy to be God.
Put it on. Put it on.
No.
As much as it has pleased Almighty God of his great mercy to take unto himself the soul of our brother Archibald, now departed, we therefore commit his body to the ground in sure and certain hope of the resurrection of eternal life. We shall see him no more until that glorious day. We therefore now commit his body to the ground, dust to dust, ashes to ashes. Rest, our brother, rest on until that eternal day when all of us will be judged of our sins. Blessed are the dead who die in the Lord. So says the Spirit, they rest from their labor. Therefore, they are before the throne of God and they are there to serve him night and day.
Oh!
going away. I'm gonna leave this world no more strong. I'm gonna sing redemption story. I'm gonna walk those streets of glory by and by. I'm gonna walk those streets of glory by and by and by. I'm gonna walk those streets of glory by and by. I'm gonna walk those streets of glory. I'm gonna sing redemption story. I'm gonna walk those streets of glory by and by. Oh, by and by, when the morning comes, when all the saints of God shall gather home, we will tell the story how we overcome. We will understand it better by and by. Yes, by and by, when the morning comes, when all the saints of God shall gather home, we will tell the story how we overcome. We will understand it better by and by.
Shall I?